Hi, this is Dr. Gary Namy. Let's look at how the BP environmental disaster is probably predicated upon BP's workplace culture. It seems from credible accounts that several engineers and workers on the oil platform, prior to the explosion that killed 11 of them, had brought up problems, had recognized issues that needed to be concerned that the well was a dangerous well. But the company had made several decisions to cut costs and move faster. And in fact, those people were not only disregarded, they were ordered to shut up. And corporate personnel who came to the rig had actually overridden the decisions of the people at the rig. So indeed, there were hints that there were problems ahead, and they were ignored. Furthermore, the history comes out that this is BP's cost-cutting culture, and it's a top-down, hierarchical, sit-down, shut-up, command-and-control type place where workers who had a different opinion that were perhaps safety-oriented, and clearly the death of 11 workers is a health and safety catastrophe as well as creating the environmental catastrophe, that this is a company that just didn't give a damn about that. All right, so that's BP, and you say that's BP and it's separate. But have you noticed in your company, your state agency, or wherever it is where you have been employed, where you have been bullied or you have witnessed bullying, it is indeed the same culture. It is top down. It is the unfettered exercise of managerial prerogative. Whatever the boss says goes. And when management wants something done, it wants it done uncritically. They don't want your opinion about it. Just do it. Do it without questioning. Well, that kind of stupidity, that kind of blindness, not only leads to critically poor decisions and lower productivity, bad work and bad quality, but it leads to lack of safety. So it then becomes a health and safety issue if it's a cover-up type culture. And if it's a top-down hierarchical culture, it's an unsafe culture. Whenever I read Canadian health and safety regulations, I'm always struck by the fact that workers have the right to refuse to work in an unsafe or potentially violent situation, that they can stop work at that moment, bring in the safety officer, go off on leave while this is investigated by a safety committee, and bring to the attention of an organization that cannot be ignored a potential violation or a potential work hazard. Whereas here in the United States, those workers on the Deepwater Horizon platform stated that they were concerned and they perished because the company told them to shut up. So I think it's the great untold story here that's shared by most bullying places. People are told to shut up, to let managerial prerogative rule, and to stop your whining and stop your complaining and just learn to adjust to that jerk. And that's a horrific health and safety violation. You know, one of the messages that comes through loud and clear when you speak to Europeans, and we're just back from the International Conference on Workplace Bullying in Wales, is this is a health and safety violation. It is first and foremost a threat to employee health. And that, of course, is central to our definition of workplace bullying. It's repeated health-harming mistreatment. That's why there's a movement. Its ability to traumatize people is why it has to stop. So please, put this in the context of health and safety and the workplace culture that either fosters health and safety and cares about its workers or one that tramples them. It doesn't take a BP disaster to have bullying occur. It happens at a much lower level on a much more routine frequency. It is indeed a silent epidemic. Thank you, and please visit the Workplace Bullying website at workplacebullying.org.